Hello, my viewers. Once again, I welcome you to Elimu TV, which is your station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi Francis, and this is lesson 2, which is covering center of gravity of irregular shaped objects. And we will also be able to look at center of, that is the states of equilibrium. And the goals of this lesson are as indicated there. Number one, that is to determine the center of gravity of a square with a cut off at the center and an irregular shaped object, ramina. How can we get its center of gravity? We'll also list down the states of equilibrium and state the application of stability in various areas that we may need to have its application. So, a square with a cut at its center. How do we get the center of gravity? Remember that this is still a regular shaped object. The point is that there is nothing at the center. It's just an empty space. So the center of gravity is within its center. We get its center by constructing the diagonals. Once you construct the diagonals, the point of intersection of the diagonals becomes the center of gravity. So, once again, construct the diagonals. The point of intersection of the diagonals is the center of gravity. So, what about an irregular shaped object? There's a procedure that we need to follow. Number one, we make 3 holes on the irregular shaped object, ramina. Then we suspend it by a rod through hole A, and we need a plumb line. We tie a plumb line on the rod side of the cardboard. And then once they have stopped swinging, we draw a vertical line through the cardboard as set by the plumb line. And then we repeat the experiment using the holes B, C, and the point of intersection becomes the center of gravity. We can try to balance the cardboard using the tip of a pencil just to observe whether it balances. Once again, throughout the procedure, what did we say? We make 3 holes, for instance, A, B, C, and then we suspend it using a rod, or you can use a cramp and stand, and then we hang a plumb line, and then once it stops swinging, we trace the line as traced by the plumb line. We draw a line there, and then we repeat the procedure by suspending it again using the different holes, that is B, C, or you can, that is the 3 different holes. And once at each of these suspension, we trace the line which is marked by the plumb line. And there we have the point of intersection of the 3 lines as traced out by the plumb line. So what are the results? If from our diagram, which we have here, ABC, after tracing or following throughout the procedure, we get the 3 lines and the point of intersection of the 3 lines after suspending it from the 3 holes becomes the center of gravity. And therefore, once we suspend or we balance this lamina at this point, it balances, that indicating that that is the center of gravity. So when it comes to equilibrium, states of equilibrium, there is one point that we need to understand, that is when a body is at rest, all the forces acting upon it balance one another. And there are 3 states of stability. And the 3 states of stability are namely stable, unstable, and neutral. We start with stable equilibrium. To be able to understand the stable equilibrium, we consider the following kind of shaped object, in which we have to consider the position of the center of gravity and the base area. Those are 2 key things that we need to consider first, for us to be able to understand the state of equilibrium. Once again, we consider the position of the center of gravity and the base area. And in addition to that, it's important for us to consider the line of action of force, that is through the base. So if this triangle is tilted at a given angle, As long as the line of action remains within the base area, this will always be stable. What about other states of stability? We have unstable equilibrium. Now, considering the same triangle, but in this case, it is an inverted one, upside down, and therefore we have the base area, once again, being the tip and the line of action from the center of gravity, which is up there, acting along this very small area. So once we tilt this triangle at a very slight angle, you'll find that it does not go back to its initial position. It topples. So this indicates that it is in unstable state of equilibrium. So once again, we consider the position of the center of gravity, the line of action, and the base area. This gives us that once we tilt it and the line of action is outside the base area, then it is unstable. We have neutral equilibrium. What is neutral state of equilibrium? Considering once again the base area and the center of gravity. For this kind of a ship, the center of gravity is at the center, and the line of action will always be throughout the base, since it does not change. So we can't per se say that this kind of a ship will topple at one point or from one direction to another, since it will always remain at the line of action of the force will always remain to be at the base area. That is, the line of action is always within the base. So what are the factors that affect stability of objects? As mentioned earlier, we have talked about the position of the base area. That is the base area itself, or the position of the center of gravity. So as long as the line of action remains within the base area, then it does not topple. In this case, the first vehicle here, the position of gravity is there, and the line of action is as indicated. So as long as this line of action goes outside the base area, then this vehicle will topple. The other thing, in the second diagram here, you realize that the line of action of the base, the line of action of force from the center of gravity is within the base area at the same angle. At the same angle. They have been tilted at the same angle, but the line of action of the second vehicle remains within the base area. So the vehicle will not topple at any given point. What about which other factor, as we have talked about again, is the position of the center of gravity? We have the base area and the position of the center of gravity. What is the effect on the center of gravity? We consider a double-decker bus where we have its center of gravity being this point. So once again, it is not advisable for passengers to stand on the upper deck of this bus. Why? This is because it raises the center of gravity. Once the center of gravity has been raised, if this bus tilts at any given angle, the line of action will be outside the base area and the bus will topple. That is, it cannot go back to its initial position. Base area, once again, when you look at the bus which we have here, the center of gravity G, the line of action is within the base area. Even though this bus has been tilted at a given angle, it is still stable since the line of action of force is within the base area. But if it tilts at an angle, at a point where the line of action of the base is the line of action of force is outside the base area, therefore this bus cannot regain its original state of stability. Definitely it will top to the left, and this indicates that this bus will no longer be stable. So the base area is very important, so it should be wide to ensure that the line of action of the force remains within the base area. What application do we have? We have these in motor industry. Luggage compartments have been built at the they have been built at the bottom part of this bus. This helps to increase the stability. We also have the racing, the motor car racing. These vehicles are built to in a way that the base area is very wide and they are also short. That is, the height is very low to ensure that the center of gravity is very low and they have a very wide base area. The other thing is we also have the stool, the tripod stand and the base, that is the Bunsen burner. They are all made with a wide base. Wide base increases the base area and the line of action of the force will still or will always remain to be within the base area. When a person carries water using a bucket, this person will definitely have to lean on one side. What does or what is the reason of this? This is to increase the area and this makes this person to become more stable. So to be able to understand, to see whether we have got the concept, we can answer the following question. State the three states of stability, or what are the three states of stability? Write down the factors that affect the stability of an object, and also we can explain why a person carrying water using a bucket will have to lean on one side. You can refer this on Physics Students Book 2, and you can as well as contact us through an SMS or our Facebook page, all at Elimu TV on YouTube, or you can give us a tweet at Elimu TV _KE.